So for those of you wanting to doze off early tonight, why don't you watch my latest YouTube video on the hydrodynamic law? This should certainly get you to sleep promptly. So hydrodynamic law, we talk about on the forum quite a bit, basically says that if we double the flow in a circuit, we'll get a pressure loss across that circuit 4 times greater than it before the increase in flow. That's the same for valves. I believe it's the same for pipework fittings, etc., etc., although the formulas are slightly different for those. But I've just written a few pages out, just condensed it down a little bit to run through this. It's a bit of a glance over. I've cut out a lot of the complicated language, and I hope I haven't made it more confusing in the process. So hopefully this should be able to give us an insight fairly easily. So hydrodynamic law, if we double the flow in a system, the delta P will increase by 4 times. Flow and delta P are proportional. So the relationship shown by the following formula, then that's delta P1 divided by the flow 1 squared is equal to delta P2 divided by flow 2 squared. Hope I said that correctly. Delta P being the pressure difference across a valve component or system, and Q equaling the flow. And for this, the pressure difference is in bar and the flow is in cubic meters per hour. I don't really understand why, but they are. With this information, we're able to calculate the pressure loss through a valve component or system. If we have an initial set of the required data, the data needed is initial flow rate and pressure drop, delta P. This fact is used to give a base value to an industry standard for valves and other components. The industry have settled on the flow rate required to give rise to a pressure drop of 1 bar across the valve or component. This value is referred to as a KV value. We can see KV and KVS values on components. KVS is a KV value stated on an adjustable valve when it's fully open. A KV value can be used at any position or adjustment of a valve other than fully open. So if we find that a 1 bar delta P occurs at a flow rate of 2.1 cubic meters an hour, the KV or KVS value will be 2.1. So I hope that's clear. So basically the KV value is used in the industry to give us the base data needed to apply the formula at the top here to calculate the pressure drop that we'll experience at any flow we want to choose that is not the same flow as the one used to achieve the 1 bar flow rate to get the KV value. God, that sounded very complicated. Right, so basically what we've ended up here, we've pushed our water through our valve. We've got delta P of 1 bar and the flow rate at that point was 2.1 cubic meters an hour, giving us a KV value of 2.1. And if it's a control valve and it's fully open, we would call that the KVS value. So we can test the formula. If we've got this formula and it will do what we say it'll do, and also we know that if we double the flow, the delta P will 4 times greater, then we can apply the formula to test that out. So we've just worked out the other side. We've got a valve with a KVS value or KV value of 2.1. So delta P1 is 1 bar, which is what we've used for the standard. Our flow rate is 2.1 cubic meters per hour, which gives us the KV or KVS value. We're trying to work out what our flow rate will be, our pressure drop will be if we double the flow. So here we've got 2.1 cubic meters per hour. We've doubled the flow to 4.2 cubic meters per hour. We don't know what the resulting delta P will be. So So if we then work this out, we'll break it down. We'll do the square of 2.1, 4.41, and we'll do the square of 4.2, 17.64. Then we will divide the 1 by 4.41. So that comes to 0.227 equals x divided by 17.64. We then multiply both sides by the division side of this one, which cancels out of this side, or moves it up across rather, giving us 0.227 by 17.64 equals x. And then if we do the maths there, we come to an answer of 4. So x is equal to 4, which means that if we double the flow, we get 4 times the delta p, proving the formula to be correct. Right, now not only can we use this information to calculate the pressure loss that arises from a change of flow, it can be used to select a valve that will give a chosen pressure loss. Given any two parts of the equation, the third can be calculated. And through transposition, we end up with 3 useful formulas. So if we want to know the KV value of a valve that we want to buy, if we know our flow rate and the delta P that we want, so we've got our mass flow, for example, we want to have a valve that's going to give us a pressure drop of X bar. Q divided by the square root of the pressure drop we're after will give us the KV value. We can then go shopping and find a valve with a or a component with a nearest KV value to that. If we wanted to know what the flow will be when we apply a valve of a given KV value, or we know the KV value and we change the flow, Q, the flow will equal the KV times the square root of delta P. And the other side of this, if we want to know what the delta P will be, we've got Q divided by KV value squared. KV and KVS are used for valves and some components, pipes and fittings use different calculations. So I'm going to do a little bit later on the other formulas used for losses in straight pipes, Reynolds numbers, turbulent and laminar flows, and pressure losses in fittings. I've written them out already actually, but so I wouldn't confuse today with those two. Also at the moment I'm working on the next section related to this, which is the valve authority. But I think at the moment if we can work on this piece and get an understanding of KV values, once we've got that under our belt, we can move on to valve authority and to the other types of pressure losses, loss calculations. Okay, so I hope that helps. And if you need any clarification, just post up your questions and I'll try to help. So I will be posting this again on my YouTube channel. And if you're watching this on my YouTube channel, please give me a like, give me a thumbs up, and subscribe. Thank you very much.